guys. Well, hey, who are you? Hey, what was that? What? Oh, that? That was just a less superior variant of myself. What? You want to learn how to do that too? It's the time twister effect from Loki. I can teach you, but just remember that using the time twister too much can be dangerous. Well, if you insist. If you're in for the ride, just download and open PowerDirector and follow along then. Oh great, you're here for another tutorial. Today we're learning about the Loki time twister transition. Your camera shouldn't have any movement while filming, so the first thing you'll need to do is use a tripod. Once that's set up, we're gonna take three shots. One in your starting position where you can do some movement to make the scene look natural, then one shot in your ending position with movement where you act out something resembling being pushed. And then lastly, one empty shot of the space you're using. And now you're ready to edit. God, that variant was annoying. Let's try this one. Ugh. All right. Let's adjust PowerDirector layout first so that we have a smoother workflow. First, we're gonna widen our view of the timeline by pulling up the handle at the top. Then we're gonna add a fourth track at the bottom by right-clicking on the sidebar, then selecting Add Tracks. Then we will adjust the audio tracks by right-clicking on the sidebar once more, selecting Adjust Audio Track Height, and then clicking Small. This will make all of your audio track heights shorter and should give you more space to work with for the video tracks. Get on with the edit already. Okay, so impatient. After importing the three clips onto our library, we're gonna drag the empty shot onto the first track. Then we're gonna drag the other two clips onto the second track. After that, we're gonna use the scissors to trim any unwanted parts. Move your playhead to the last frame of the first clip. Let's call it clip A. Then take a snapshot by pressing the camera icon. Then do the same for the first frame of your second clip, which we will call clip B. So now you should have snapshots of your starting and ending position. Now we're gonna split off the last five frames of clip A and then the first five frames of clip B. Then we will overwrite clip A with snapshot A and do the same with clip B and snapshot B. For the following steps, we will work on the snapshots one by one. Let's start by highlighting snapshot A, then click Edit. We will go to the Tools drop-down menu, then select Mask Designer. In the Mask Designer, we will create a custom mask by first clicking the button that looks like a pencil. Then we will click on the Auto Object Selection tool, which should create a dotted line around the subject ourselves. If the outline doesn't look like it fits perfectly around the image, then we can use the plus and minus smart brush to edit the mask. Once you're satisfied with that, we'll click the OK button to leave this view, then go down to add a feather to the mask. For the feathering, we will just change the number to 1, as we only need a tiny bit of this effect. Then we'll go into Effects and search for the Style Effect drop-down menu. Search for the Style option, then type in Radial Blur in the search bar at the top. Drag and drop the radial blur onto the snapshot. Highlight snapshot A, then enter into the keyframe settings. Ugh, keyframes. Keyframes are so complicated. Have a little patience, will you? Keyframes can be easy once you get the hang of it. Anyway, once you've entered into the keyframe settings, find the drop-down menu for clip attributes, then scroll down until you find the option for opacity. Set a keyframe at the beginning of the snapshot by pressing the diamond button next to opacity. Then drag the playhead to the end of the snapshot and set the opacity to 0. Now we will copy and paste snapshot A 2 times into the tracks below. Make sure you highlight the track you are copying over to before you do the paste. Highlight the second copy of snapshot A, then change the opacity settings at the start to 60%. Then do the same with the third copy, but change it to 30%. This will create a ghosting effect. Now let's go into the keyframe settings in each of the snapshot A copies. Set a keyframe in each frame of the snapshots and add a keyframe using the diamond button next to the positions option. Change the X and Y values for every keyframe. This part can be as random as you want it, as it'll make your image look like it's bouncing around. Repeat all the steps for snapshot B, this time with the opacity settings adjusted from 20% to 100%, 40% to 100%, and finally 60% to 100%. This will create the effect of your image appearing out of thin air in your ending position. And with that, And with that, you can recreate your own time twister effect from Loki. Remember to like and subscribe and... And don't forget to download Power Director because it's free.